அசிஸ்டன்ட் ப்ரொஃபஸர் அண்ட் ரிசர்ச் சூப்பர்வைசர் அப்துல் அகீம் காலேஜ் அட்டானமஸ் மேல் விஷாரம். ஐ எம் வெரி மச் பிளஷர் டு வெல்கம் த பார்ட்டிசிபேட் ஹூ கேதர் த்ரூ த ஜூம் மீட் அண்ட் ஐ ஆல்சோ வெல்கம் அவர் காலேஜ் டுடே செக்ஷன். ஐ எம் ஷுர் தட் திஸ் வெபினார் இஸ் கெட்டிங் டு அன்கவர் த டேலண்ட் அண்ட் எசென்சியல் குவாலிட்டி இட் இஸ் பை த நோயிங் அவர் செல்ஃப் இன் எ பெட்டர் வே.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I call our principal, ma'am, to introduce our chief guest.
Voice not hearing, ma'am. Voice is not hearing.
Sir, is it audible now?
Yes. Welcome, madam.
Very good morning to one and all. I am very happy and feel proud to introduce Dr. S. Muhammad Rafi, Assistant Professor and Research Supervisor, PG and Research Department of Commerce, C. Abdul Hakim College, Melvisharam. He has started his career and profession in 2001, and he is having 21 years of teaching experience in UG and PG. He has a specialized knowledge and is well versed in finance, marketing, HR, and income tax. He has published 21 international and 12 national journals. He has also participated in 45 workshops and attended FDP. He has organized and coordinated 6 seminars in national and international level. He is also contributing for research. Yes, he has produced 10 MPhil graduates and 2 PhDs. At present, he is guiding 4 PhD scholars under the guideship of Thiruvalluvar University. He is also acted as a resource person and delivered 14 special lectures on various topics at national and international level seminars and conferences. He also acted as an examiner in various autonomous colleges and universities. He is a board member and question paper sitter of Madras University, Bharathiyar University, and SRM University, Kattamkulathur, Chennai. I'm very proud to share one valuable information about today's resource person. He is conducting coaching classes for CET, NET, PGTRB, and many more competitive examinations, and has produced many qualified academicians during a decade. He is well known to me for past 15 years, and he is not only a good academician, but also a very helpful, noble, kind, and very helpful, kinder person, and having wide and well-versed knowledge in his field. He is having busy schedule in his field. Sir, thank you very much for accepting our invitation. Though you are very busy with your own academic schedule, you have accepted our invitation, and you are spending your valuable time with us for enlightening our students with your valuable special lecture on the topic digital marketing today. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Now I address the chief guest from C. Abdul Hakim College, Dr. S. Muhammad Rafiq, Assistant Professor and Research Supervisor, Department of Commerce.
Okay, madam. Madam, please allow me to share my screen, madam, because it was disabled. Allow me to share my screen. Because you have disabled me to sharing the screen. Can you allow me to share the screen? Or whether you can
yes, share? Sir.
Wait, madam, something happened. Okay. Are you able to visible the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, welcome. Okay. Oh, good morning to everyone. Really, first of all, I thank to Mahalakshmi College management, correspondent secretary, as well as the principal, who has given an opportunity to give a special lecture, guest lecture on digital marketing. I thanks to the head of the department of BBA, as well as head of the department of computer applications, for given an opportunity to share some experience in digital marketing towards the students. Really, I congratulate the Arcot Mahalakshmi College management, principal, and organizers for selecting this good topic, which will be very useful to the students. Really, we are now living in a digital era. Digital marketing has become more famous after involvement of latest technologies in business. It has completely changed the old marketing methods and compelled marketers to stay connected with their buyers or customers via internet for selling their products and services. Consequently, the marketers must consider and analyze both advantages and disadvantages of digital marketing while planning the best marketing and setting business goals. Why? Due to high efficiency and effectiveness, digital marketing has recognized by all business entities, and now it's growing faster every passing day. Soon it will become easier for small businesses to compete their large scale competitors at same platform. This digital marketing plays important role in this era. Everyone know about this. Before that, we should understand what is digital marketing. The digital marketing means it refers to marketing campaign that appears on computer, phone, tablet, and other devices. Nowadays, in every village as well as rural place, every individuals, whether he may be educated or uneducated, now they are willing to purchase whatever it may be through online mode, to online shopping. So that's is called digital marketing. This digital marketing is often compared with traditional marketing, as well as in the traditional methods, we are going to the shop and we are purchasing what we need. We have to wait for to buy our products. But now, the customers, the consumers have no time to wait in queue, and they need sophisticated products. They need so many advanced products because with the help of a digital marketing. So this digital marketing now become very, very important in marketing. So before that, we should understand how this marketing has evolved, how it comes from now. So on this occasion, first we have to understand how the digital marketing, growth in 2 or 3 decades. For example, in 1990s, first the compute service was introduced. After that, in 1991, the American online shopping was introduced. As well as in 1992, the SMS messaging was introduced, and in 1994, the first online display ad was introduced. After that, in 2000, the Google mobile advertising was introduced in 2000. And after that, in 2005, the Google Analyst, SOE, and YouTube was introduced, and it become more popularity. After that, the Facebook ads come in 2008. Now it becomes very, very popular. And you know how the iPad, Instagram, and other things are now using. So this is the evolution stage and the growth of marketing, as well as the evolution of digital marketing. What happened in 3 decades? So what happened in 3 decades and how it comes in 1990s? Computers was not popular, as well as in this stage there will be no popularity in computers. After some later years, the personal computers was used, and using emails after 2 years, between 96, number of peoples connected with internet. Nearly 16 to 70 million peoples were connected in this period, 1996. After that, it becomes more popular in 1996 as well as 1998. After that, in 2000s, after one decade, 90 to 99, the digital market becomes some boom in 2000s. There are number of internet users continues to grow, as well as yes. So in 2000s, there are 361 billion internet users have used, as well as in 2000, there will be a very large influential platforms appear during the time, and new corporations like MyFace in 2005, it sell its products nearly $580, as well as in 2008, it becomes 75 million users as a digital marketing. Next one, LinkedIn launched 2002 as a professional social media platform, going strong in these days. A year later, WordPress, MySpace appeared in digital marketing. As well as in 2010, there were 1.97 billion internet users in the world, a significant increase from 361 million in 2000. Likewise, this marketing was went very fast through the Google, as well as Google make a foundation for digital marketing in 2010. As well as, what about the present? So what about the present? Today, more than 3.5 billion people are used social media, which is about 45% of population starts from 2019, as well as past 2 years. Past two years, there are so many consumers are using digital marketing, as well as Facebook still the most used social media platform with over 2.45 billion monthly active users. When it comes to digital marketing, 94% of Facebook ad revenue comes from the mobile, as well as Facebook has released the information that over 3 million business actively advertise on a platform. So people know everyone have now using these Facebooks, and everyone have as well as the email address as well as Facebook ID. So with the help of this Facebook, now so many consumers are connecting with the so many companies' products. As well as nowadays, nearly 54% of people use social media to learn more about products and brands. Whatever you need, nowadays people went to their mobile and they are searching. There are so many apps are there. There will be some Amazon apps, Flipkart apps, Snapdeal apps, as well as Kitchen Hub. Like that, so many apps are there. So varieties of product you can search even within your native itself. Wherever you go and you can search the products, you can search the company, and it will be very, very useful, and it will be very, very convenient. And we can see so many models with the help of digital marketing era, as well as this digital marketing on online shopping makes more comfortable for the peoples, as well as it becomes e-commerce. And nowadays it grows very, very popularly, as well as now it was expected that in the nearly 2040, mostly 95% of purchase will be made online only. Okay, so we have to understand now in 2021, and within few weeks we can be stepped to 2022, as well as this our 2022 becomes a lot of changes in marketing strategies. The companies want to make a lot of strategies to make their product, and they compete it with so many companies. The large companies are competing with this e-commerce, as well as nearly we expected that 95% of purchases will be made online in 2040. You think about that. In after 20 years, after 18 years, after 18 years, there will be no shops. There will be the peoples are not willing to go shops. They whatever need, they can purchase through only digital marketing, through only online marketing. Now itself, in Sundays, the peoples are not cooking, the peoples are not doing anything because of the Suzy, as well as so many ads, and so because of so many companies are providing whatever we need, whatever it may be, a fruit, whatever it may be, a tiffin, whatever it may be, a lunch, whatever it may be, they will table in our house itself. So this is the growth of digital marketing. So in this digital marketing, it comprises of 5 strategies. What are the 5 strategies? First is one is digital technology, another one is digital data and digital channel, digital matrix, digital devices. So first of all, you have to know what is meant by digital technology. So how it comes? So digital technology have some important strategy technologies. For example, it uses like customer data platform. And in this customer data platforms, there will be some marketing automations. So with the help of marketing automations, the marketing have increased as well as it retained the customers and it builds a high quality sales pipeline. So with the help of these marketing automations, they are building the customers and they are retentioning the customers. What is meant by retentions? So for example, when we are providing, when we are supplying, when we are giving what the consumer needs, when the consumer satisfies your product and he will not change the company, he will not change the brand, he will not change your wish. Like that, when the consumer adopted with the brand, he will not never go to another product. That is called customer retention. Customer retention is a policy of which every company efficiently and effectively move towards. They have to retain the customers. So this is the marketing automations as well as the customer relationship management. So what is meant by customer relationship management? So customer relationship management means it is a sales force adopted by the companies with the help of giving quality conversions. So with the help of quality, the peoples are making a good long relationship and building a relationship marketing with the company, as well as with the help of analytics, with the help of metrics. What are that? That is the Google Analytics is there, Mixpanel is there. With the help of Mixpanel, with the help of Google Analytics, they use their marketing strategies, as well as they use various tools like SEOs. So what is meant by SEO? SEO. SEO means search engine operations. So like that, digital data. So what is meant by digital data? So here, with the help of digital data, they have so many products and they have good profiles and they engaging in patterns which helps the businesses. Whatever you want, you go to the digital data and you search what type of product you need and what type you have to purchase. These all things are coming under digital data, as well as there will be some digital channels. So what is meant by digital channels? With the help of digital channels, the collection of paid, owned, and earned channel utilized to build engagement with target market through several ways, such as advising, emails, messaging, search engine, and social networks. So nowadays, there will be a good platform for adding our advertisement like digital channels. There will be also one famous serial is running in Vijay TV that you know somewhere knows about Varkya Lakshmi. Did Varkya Lakshmi is a woman, he is a housewife, and he is doing his household expenses or household work. After that, he is engaging a business. He started a business and it will be reached by the social networks. With the help of the social ad, he was reached more and he becomes a growing entrepreneur in that serial. Like that, the students have so many opportunities. You can start a business, small business, and you can make a digital channel. And you can use your ads in the digital channel. And with the help of digital channel, the social network will be very effective. And with the help of social network, you can reach your products. As well as there will be another devices that the digital matrix and digital devices. So you know what is meant by. Can you hear me?
Hey.
Hello, can you hear me? The audio is good.
No, sir.
Hello, the organizers. Hello, the organizers. Hello. Hello, the coordinator as well as the organizer. Hello. 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 Can you anyone give me the response?
Yes,
anyone
sir.
Give me response?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
My audio is audible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Yes, sir.
The screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Are you following me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, nice. Very nice. Very nice. Okay. So, dear students, because now there are so many opportunities in India, because we have more than 120 crores of populations. Why the foreign companies, why the foreign direct investments, why they are wish to come here? What is the reason? Because we have lot of populations. India is a consumer market. India is a consumer market. You think about that. Every morning, every Indian is going to take tea. Whether he may, some people take tea, whether some people may take coffee, some people may take Horlicks, or some people may go for Boost, or some people go for raw milk. Like that, in every morning, every consumer, every people need paste, as well as toothpaste, as well as toothbrush. So without brush, there will be individuals you can't found. You go for your home, there are how many peoples you have. For example, in your family, 10 members. Means how many brush you need? 10 members, you need a brush. Like that, in every activity, for example, morning to night, what you are engaging, from morning to night, whatever you use, that is your marketing products. You go for tea, or you go for coffee, you go for toothpaste, you go for cloth, you go for lunch, you go for dinner, whatever need, whatever you go, whatever it may be, you are doing any activity, you are purchasing, and you are doing some marketing activities. Like that, India is a consumer market. India is a consumer market. So whatever you produce, whatever you manufacture, it will be how lot of consumers to purchase the products. So only the foreign companies, so only the foreigners, the FDIs are want to start their business in India. So how many, do you know how many Coca-Colas are producing per day, and how many people are consuming the Coca-Colas, Pepsis, as well as like that? So India is a very good market. India is a consumer oriented nation. Because other peoples in other states, you go for UAE, you go for Dubai, you go for Saudi Arabia, you go for France, you go for Italy. What is the population? The population is very, 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 very less. So our Tamil Nadu become one country. Our Uttar Pradesh become two nations. Our Uttar Pradesh becomes two nations. So our population have the 40% of 30% of nearly world population India's have. So these digital devices, with the help of smartphones, with the help of tablets, with the help of desktops, with the help of computers, now we are able to mobile friendly, and we make a search engine, and we can reach our product to digital devices. So these are the various digital market type, various types of digital marketings. So what are that? So first one is that marketing with the help of content marketing is there, social media marketing is there, pay per click is there, search engine optimization is there, electronic billboard is there, radio, TV ads, and mobile marketings. These are the various types of digital marketings comes to our hand with the mobile. So this is the most important device, that is search engine optimizations. These search engine optimizations is called a Google. So whatever you need, whatever you want, you cannot purchase one your parents, you cannot purchase your husband, you cannot purchase your child, except that you can purchase whatever you want. So that is, that is whatever you need, whatever you want, it will be charged by the search engine optimizations. So this is the very, very important tool which increase the number of website visitors by ranking highly in Google. Like that, there are 90% of global search market is the branch of digital marketing. But dear students, this this is the pay-per-click. This pay-per-click, you know, with the help of pay, with the help of click, you can purchase your products. You can pay with the Google, there are Google Pay, Phone Pay, Amazon Pay, like that. There are so many products are purchased by pay by clicks. As well as there will be a one type of marketing strategy. That one type of marketing, digital marketing, is that content marketing. So what is meant by that content marketing? The content marketing is a service which helps and you make to create some blog post, vlogs, pictures, montages, and with the help of these blogs, you can create the content marketings. As well as with the help of this content marketing, you place your product and you can make your investment in this content marketing, and you can reach a good target audience. As well as email marketing with the help of clicks, with the help of clicks, with the help of emails, but whatever you, when you are opening your mails, you can get so many ads. When you are opening your mail and when you are working with your computer by internet, you can get so many ads. You can get so many personalized trackings, as well as you can get so many emails about the products, about the company, about the financial markets, like that. So this is also a one tool of digital marketing. As well as next one is that viral marketing. So what is meant by viral marketing? With this, the help of, with this help of marketing, the consumers share information about companies, goods, and services through social networks. So this is called viral marketing. So we are getting messages. We are getting messages from email. We are getting messages from Twitter. We are getting messages from WhatsApp. We are getting messages from Telegram. So the Facebooks. These are the social networks. With the help of social networks, with the help of Facebooks, you can reach your information, you can share your information, you can give your information to the consumers. So this is called viral marketing. So this is one tool. Another one is the mobile. Mobile marketing is another tool for digital marketing. So it help. For example, you are going to purchase any product in Peter England or any other company products. One time you have purchased product and when you are giving your numbers, you often get messages. There will be a deal, there will be a discounts, there will be coupons, there will be some royalty points are there. If you purchase these, you will get these discounts. Like that, with the help of these messagings, the company will send the messages through your mobile and he will sell your products with the help of this mobile marketing. As well as this is a traditional method of marketing that is called radio and TV ads. So with the help of this radio you can reach your products to the consumers. This is the one method. As well as electronic billboard is another strategy, another tool which reaches digital marketing. So how does the digital marketing for all business? Yes, this is the question. Does digital marketing work for all business? Yes. There will be a business to business. So business to business, that is called industries and organization, can make great use of digital marketing since their top market to generate mainly many leads as they can. So it helps, this digital marketing helps the business to business to make several benefits. And using and building a brand image with saving their time and money. So that consumer to business to consumer, business to consumer, B2C. So the business to business as well as consumer to business. For example, you have to purchase any Samsung product, you can go for Amazon, you can go for Flipkart and you direct purchase with some companies. So that is called consumer to business to consumer. It is a highly engaging and interactive, useful content in digital marketing. So next, now come to the important things. What is that digital marketing opportunities of digital marketing? So what are the actual opportunities of digital marketing? The first one is easy. First one is that easy consumer reach. Digital marketing is an effective way of communication for companies to target large number of potential consumer at same time. These with the help of the social marketing, with the help of education. Madam, mute, someone is talking. Okay, yes. So what are the opportunities in digital marketing? The first one is, it is very easy consume and reach. With the help of social media, with the revolutions, these marketing activities on different social media, such as Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Pinterest. Madam, please mute your audio. Can you mute your audio, please?
Okay, sir.
Yes, there is some disturbance. Okay, and next now come to our important topic, that what are the opportunities of digital marketing? So the opportunities of digital marketing is, first one is easy consumer reach. As well as next one is the direct advertising. So now the companies can easily show their advertisement for the product and services on different digital channels. But on a good online advertisement strategy and promotional tools can help the digital marketers to perform well, highly competitive marketing environment. As well as the third opportunity is perpetually displaying the ads. So what is that? these makes more accessible to target customers at any time or any place. So this is the perpetually displaying ads. So there is no time and place limitations for prospects to visit any website and view ads. Whenever you have your time, whenever you need, you can visit the ads and you see four-step process to display ads on web page as well. And another opportunity is global advertisements. Now, one product, you can make ad through this e-marketing, through the e-channels, you can, you have to reach other countries across geographical boundaries. Not only your product was ads in Tamil Nadu or any other state, only in India, not like that. With the help of this digital marketing, your product reached to other countries across the geographical boundaries, as well as easy brand. So it with the help of these easy brand promotions, it take very great advantages to the consumers reach and communicate it to clients successfully. And there will be another opportunities in digital marketing is that effective cost, effective channels. So it is very less. For example, you have to give advertisement in TV channels, leading channels. You have to pay more. You have to pay more for that. But in digital marketing, the cost is very less comparing to TV, comparing to radio, comparing to newspapers, comparing to the banners. So with the help of these, so the social media marketing platform such as Facebook, Twitter, Google Plus, LinkedIn, WhatsApp, blogs, Instagram, and YouTube, etc., also provide a huge traffic source. As well as it will be very convenient. Other opportunity is it will be very convenient to shop online, whatever it may be the time. Online, due to more popularity and the capabilities of digital marketing, customers have become more convenient to shop online at any time, 24/7 basis. Digital marketing has opened up an opportunity for companies and retailers to direct its customers to an outlet of online store, as well as there will be some accountability of marketings. So what are that? What is the accountability of marketing? Digital marketing also helps marketers to evaluate and audit their online content for quality purpose. These are the opportunities for digital marketings. And there will be some limitations and there are some challenges of digital marketing. What are the challenges? So first one is limitation of internet access. For example, in the urban areas, the towns, the cities, we have good internet access. But in villages, in remote areas, we don't have internet access. There are so many individuals, there are so many customers wish to purchase their product through digital marketing tools, but with the limitation of internet access, with the poor internet connections, the digital marketing can be unsuccessful in these areas having no or limited internet accessibility. So the government has to take an initiative to make good internet access in every rural areas, as well as what is the another challenge of digital marketing is that is limited consumers, because India have more than 120 populations, but how many states have good infrastructure and how many states have good internet access is very few, because the metro cities like Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi, as well as Calcutta, as well as IT park like Hyderabad, as well as Bangalore, these are the leading states which provide good internet facilities towards the customers. But other state likewise, western and northern states like Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Bihar, Assam, in like that, there will be very low internet accesses. So with the help of low internet accesses, the digital marketing cannot be go reach in that positions. The company's brand image cannot be reached that rural and remote area. This is the another challenges of digital marketing. And next challenge is that high competition. Next challenge is that high competition brands. So because now the small companies can't able to compete with the highly competition companies, for example, there are so many high products, high quality are there, body is there, as well as iPhone is there, as well as in electronics, there are so many companies are in a large number of consumers, but the small companies, the small firms cannot compete with their high competition companies. So this is the another challenges of digital marketing, as well as a risk of hacking strategies. Yes, nowadays there will be so many hacking promotional strategies are involved in digital channels and internet. That is one of the drawback of digital marketings, because the hackers or the competitors can easily track and copy the valuable promotional strategies, as well as re-owned company and utilize their purposes. For example, you are using a good strategy. And you are adopted the update strategies. These strategies will be hacked by so many companies. So this is another challenges of digital marketing. And next one is anti-brand activities. So this is the another challenge of digital marketing, that even a person or group of person can harm the image of recognized brand through double ganger, as well as anti-brand activities. We have to be more caution about these anti-brand activities. And next last one is there will be a limited products. There will be a limited products. So these are the challenges of digital marketing. So we can discuss how this digital marketing make very useful. Okay, so this digital marketing has a buzzword in last of decades. E-commerce has revolutionized the concept of business from physical aspects of delivery to virtual aspects of marketing and selling. These digital activities are an increasing important part of any marketing and sales strategy. So there is a paradigm of shift in how business is to conducted from traditional model to e-commerce model. There is a under expansion of products and markets, and at the same time, challenges are emerging to make players more competitive in the field. Today, the most companies are either thinking about or pressing ahead with digital change initiative. Every company has a website. Few marketing strategies are signed up without incorporating social media. Certainly, the social media is a critical component of any digital strategy, but a holistic response to digital shift must go much further. So this, in general, though the more holistic the initiative, the greater the chance of success. We believe that, so how and act now stand to gain the best advantage. So in this point, I will end of my session. Really, it was fantastic, and I think the students are understand about what is digital marketing and what are the tools in digital, as well as what are the opportunities and what are the challenges in digital marketing. I thank to the Arcod Mahalakshmi management for organizing such a state level seminar on digital marketing, as well as I thank to the principal as well as head of the departments and friends who get this session very useful. Thank you one and all.
Thank you. Now I call our head of the department of PBA, Kimalata ma'am, to thank our.
Good afternoon to all. On behalf of Department of Business Administration and DCOM-PA, I feel it is such an honor for me to get the opportunity to thank you all dignitaries for today's session. First of all, let me start by giving glory to the Almighty God for making today's webinar a great success.
Madam, first of all,
I thank you, teacher, Assistant Professor and Research Supervisor, Department of Commerce, Sri Abdulaziz College, Meljitaram, to take out time from his busy schedule to grace the event. Thank you, sir. Thank you for inspiring and encouraging us with your words on this special day. I extend my gratitude to our Chairman, sir, Dr. K. Bhaskar, Vice Chairman, ma'am, Mr. Sonaka Bhaskar, Secretary, sir, Mr. Kishan Kumar, and Director of MBA, Mr. Shiva Kishan Kumar ma'am, for providing immense support to make this webinar successful.